Article 176 of the Constitution. Confirms and establishes a county assembly as a state organ. That ought to perform its legislative processes without interference. This was confirmed, was stated in a petition number 32 of 2014 to the Supreme Court of Kenya. Parties are Julius Kariuki Mate and another versus Martin Nyagawambura and another. In that case, my lady, the courts explained. Yes, it is in my list of authorities. Annex. Yes. So in this case, my lady, the courts did as to the extent to which courts can interfere with the parliamentary process of other state bodies. My lady, your orders with the parliamentary process of a state forum. My lady, your orders issued on the 17th of February. Seem to be interfering with the doctrine of separation of powers.
As seen by
the applicant. This is our application. Interfering with the doctrine of separation of powers. This Honorable Court and as Article 165 of the Constitution grants the court of this sort of jurisdiction over other state organs and its powers ought to be exercised with a lot of restraint. Strange or rather limit itself, its functions, noting the prevailing circumstances of the Nairobi City Council. For the prevailing circumstances of the Nairobi City Council, which is a matter of public interest. Was well guided in reference number 1 of 2015. And the Supreme Court gave an advisory as to how the Deputy Governor will assume office. On the 16th of January and February 7th this year, through press release, Supreme Court and the courts stated that it is therefore premature and misleading and misleading for a story carried from January 6th to imply that the board is in the court, is in the Supreme Court, while the premises have not been completed. These two press releases were actually made before the ruling of this court. Guided by advisory number 1 of 2015, as to when that respondent, 1 of 2015, as to when the first, as to when that respondent, well, the interested party, should be, yes, should vet the deputy governor. My lady, starting on the first round, well, the court made an error. In the case of National Bank of Kenya Limited versus Ndongo Njau, Civil Appeal Number 211 of 1996, my lady, it was the finding of the court that a review may be granted where the court considered that it was necessary correct an apparent error or omission on part of the courts. It was correct an error or omission on the part of the court.
I'm so sorry for trying to interrupt my colleague. Perhaps it could be served to those authorities that are being relied on the hearing.
Thank you.
We have filed authorities of which the same authority is being. The petition is attached to the document. That is the advisory opinion number 1 of 2015.
Please exchange. We know that you will please exchange the documents.